HOA renovations, you know?
Yeah.
I guess we'll start the vlog here. So it is 5:45. It is the day of the Coburg Naturals, so the first local CPA show of the year anyways. Welcome to the video, guys. As you guys can see, my face is probably rounder since you saw me last. My season's done, but we're kicking off, well, I guess Jeff and Marley stepped on stage last weekend, but locally anyways, we're kicking off the season with seven competing. Kyle's returned to the stage, but his bodybuilding debut, he's also doing men's physique, his shorts are somewhere. So we got bodybuilding, we got men's physique, we got classic physique, we got bikini, and we got seven total stepping on stage today. So this morning, I'm making my rounds, checking out how everybody's looking. That'll set the pace for the day. You still have to get your second tan, correct?
Yes.
So everybody's still got to get their second tan?
And there after 8 at 6.
Perfect. And then the show starts at 10 with pre-judging. It's a split format, so pre-judging probably 10 to 1-ish. We'll have some downtime, and then finals probably kick off around 5. So it's not a huge show, but it'll be a good one. Most that are competing under me anyways are first-timers, so it's a good, you know, the Coburg show is a great place to get your feet wet. But anyways, let's see how Kyle's looking. Looking tight. Front relaxed, my friend. Chest up. Good. See a front double. Good, lock those legs. Yeah, good V taper. Relax. Front lat spread. Good. One thing Kyle has in favor is conditioning. For sure. Side chest. Okay, lock that glute in, sit into that hamstring. Good, really push into that pec. There you go, good. Keep this elbow forward a bit. Yep, good, good. Side tricep. Nice. Good, make sure that glute is on. Exhale. Same thing, push that pec. Rotate that way a little bit. Yep, just, yep, good, good. Turn around. Relax first. Can you pull your trunks up a little bit? Yeah, like the actual band, the actual like strap.
Strap?
Yeah, yeah. Up.
How high do you want
it? There you go, yeah. You want it to, I don't know if you guys can see that, these trunks aren't the best cut, but you want.
I noticed that, but compared to my white ones.
Yeah, so turn sideways actually, bud. So you see how it's arched around his hip? That's what you want.
Yeah.
You don't want it straight across because what it actually does when it's arched over your hip is it creates a V-taper illusion. So even from the back, like turn around now, it just gives a bit of a better shape to it. And actually glutes now. Yeah, that's what I want. Soften your knees, rotate out. Yes, good. Okay, back double. Good, hard on the hamstring, knees out, glutes on. I'm gonna yell glutes all day. Good, lean back. Yeah, you're conditioning. Can you come on that calf a bit more? Yes, okay, look at that. Did you guys see that? Did you catch that, Leo? That's it. Okay, your lat spread, let's see that. Okay, so I want you, because you're so diced, I want you to milk this transition. So I want you to round forward, yep, Christmas tree it, then, no, so before that even, now chest up, no, and tricep it, then hook it, and open. Okay, do that again. So round forward, Christmas tree, yep, and then chest up, boom, and then open, locked, glutes, yep, calf. That's a shot. Face front. Ab and thigh. Yeah. Woo! Can you hit this one real quick? So stay in that. So when you go ab and thigh, and then just turn a bit. Oh, I'll yell that one at you too.
I'll say a side shot. Most muscular. Last one. See, that's good though. Okay, just kind of hit some, just flex. I just want to see how we're looking.
Turn around.
There you go, right there. Actually, face. All right, go through. Just go through your routine. Yeah, you look unreal. Your shape for bikini is no question. Your quads, posings. Smooth. Yeah. Good. Go again. I'll come down from the judges. Good. So you're just saying how much better you feel compared to 2019?
Yes, I feel
and you
so
look
great.
10 times better.
I feel good, my mindset's so much better, like I just feel more clear, I feel awake, I feel full.
What do you attribute that to?
Probably the diet, just how the prep was, like how we kind of like slowly got into it.
Yeah.
Way less cardio, I think that was like exhausting my body, I was like going through a lot of emotions, a lot of stress. And
yeah.
It was a lot, this prep was great.
Much better.
It was a breeze compared to, I mean, I still went through emotions.
Oh, for sure.
Still, but
yeah, anybody listening, she's not saying it was easy.
No,
but it was much more well done.
Yes, well
right?
Like, planned, well executed, like well, like
yeah.
The guidance from you.
Yeah, I'm
sorry. It's so excited.
So, what did you weigh last time? Like 2019, do you remember?
Like 118. 118, I just had 119 this morning.
So you're basically the same, your conditioning's better, you have more muscle.
Yeah, oh yeah.
See those shoulders.
Pump the those.
Hell yeah. Alright, nothing to it but to do it now. Okay, go through your whole like transition.
Okay.
You're like Brie and you're like built for bikini. For sure. How do you feel?
Amazing.
First show?
Yeah.
Stoked?
Super pumped.
Time to do the damn thing?
Heck yeah.
Okay, have you had anything this morning yet?
Nothing.
Okay, so let's figure that out. And then you're 6:30, right? You got shit to do?
Those glutes! Beautiful. Glutes! Oh. Woo! Glutes and hammies, buddy. Lean back. Good. Transition. Hit that calf. Glutes. Yes. Good shot.
You can make some noise.
Job. Woo!
Blow it out, blow it out. Face the back. Don't pose so hard. Don't pose so hard. You're gonna tire yourself out.
There you go, blow it out. Smile. There it is, open up. Yeah!
Great job, Kyle. Stay right there.
First taste of chocolate and who knows when. How is
so
it?
So good. It's so good.
Here we go. She's worked so hard for this moment. You have yours yet?
No, it's actually like...
Here we go. Let's get it.
Okay. Favorite chocolate.
Oh, just joy. You eat yours already?
Wait, that is so good.
Oh, nice. Right?
It feels like forever.
Let's go, Vanessa!
Woo!
Let's go! Yeah, nice job!
Great job.
Nice job.
Colin.
Avery.
Woo! Woo!
Let's go, Bree. Yeah. Nice job, Bree. So we're going to close the video out here, which is kind of a recap of the show. Now, this show day vlog was not nearly as extravagant as I wanted it to be. I don't know if any of you guys watching this have ever tried to coach before, but you know, coaching one person at a show is challenging, much less trying to coach seven, especially when some of them are very first time athletes. So I had full intentions of, you know, documenting the show day a little bit more extensively. But it just didn't pan out. Moving forward, when I want to do something like that, I'll definitely kind of do, you know, where I have someone basically follow me around with this thing and, you know, they can document it versus me trying to, you know, hold the camera and get content and try to coach and all that kind of stuff. So I got a few clips throughout the day, as you guys saw, but, you know, once I got into coach mode, it was like, okay, camera's, you know, over here now. I have zero intentions of filming. So we had seven. It was the CPA Coburg Naturals, which is a close to my heart show. John, the guy that runs it, a very good relationship with him. Nothing but love and respect for the man and his passion for bodybuilding. And you can see that with how he runs the show as far as the effort he puts into, you know, supporting his athletes and giving everybody a great experience on show day, from having vendors, having, you know, massive extravagant trophies. Like, he really puts the effort in and it shows, and I will forever support, you know, not only the CPA as a whole, but the Coburg Naturals. I want to have a team there every single year. And, you know, we had seven this year. So we had Kyle, who has competed before. He did men's physique and open bodybuilding. So he made his bodybuilding debut. So that was good. Threw the trunks on and took a shot at bodybuilding. That's where, you know, he wants to pursue. But he does have a great shape for men's physique, but he's like me in that he loves the purity of bodybuilding. You know, conditioning wise, we nailed it. He was definitely the leanest up there by far. But, you know, he's a taller guy, so, you know, next to someone that's shorter, he gets just outsized a little bit, even if his conditioning, in my opinion, blew them out of the water. He just needs more muscle. He needs to fill that frame out a little bit, which is exactly what we're going to do. The plan is to take probably a solid 2 years and just really try to beef him up a little bit. Then we had Giuseppe in Classic Physique. So this was his second show. He actually did this same show, the Coburg Naturals, in 2019 with me. And a couple weeks ago, he had sent me a photo of us both on stage together, which I didn't even recall happening. So that was pretty cool to now be coaching him for his return to the stage. And, you know, we did a great job. I was happy with what we were able to accomplish in the time frame that we had. And we're looking to actually compete again as of recording this, 2 weeks at the Stephanie Worsfold Classic. So the goal there will be to bring a little bit leaner physique and probably finish off the season there. Then we had in men's physique, again, alongside Kyle, David. This was his first show, and really happy with the physique we were able to bring. You know, for a first-timer, getting in the shape that he did is commendable, because it's not easy. And, you know, if you don't know what you're getting into, it can be a bit of a shock. But David embraced, you know, every aspect of prep. You know, he nailed the diet, he stuck with the training, he followed the plan. He was an A1 client. He asked questions when needed, but, you know, at the end of the day, what I told him to do, he did, he executed on. And I was really happy with 2 second placings for him at his first show, and he's going to be joining Giuseppe on stage in a couple weeks. So that was it for the guys. Then for the girls, we had four in bikini. So we had Giuseppe's wife, Raz. She made her return to the stage as well, from being away from the stage since 2019. And our goal right out of the get-go was to bring an improved physique to the stage in comparison, which is exactly what we did. And you know, at the end of the day, that was the goal, and that's what we accomplished, which I couldn't be happier with. Her and Giuseppe, they're a power couple, man. I really admire the relationship they have, their love and support for each other. It shows, and you know, seeing them prep side by side, it was very, very enjoyable to be a part of, for sure, from a coaching perspective. Then for the rest of the girls, we had 2 first-timers. So we had Vanessa, who competed in True Novice and Open. She actually locked in first place in her Open class, which is, for those that maybe don't know, Open classes for bikini is by height. So they height the girls at registration, and then they split them up based on whatever height they kind of check in at, and then how they split the classes up is depending on the number of athletes. So in her height class, she came first, which is, you know, for a first-time competitor, is incredible. First show, first place. And then we are at this stage, I think 7 weeks. We're gonna skip the Stephanie, and we're gonna go do the Ottawa show, which is 6 or 7 weeks away. And the goal for that, from a physique perspective, I was really happy. I don't think there was much more we could do differently. I think her conditioning was good. From a muscularity standpoint, like, she's in a great spot, but I think her posing and presentation, if that's tweaked a little bit, that's where she can really stand out. Her confidence on stage, you know, she was smiling and that kind of stuff, so that's not necessarily part of the issue, but I think some tweaks with posing will make a good difference. So she was a first-timer, and then alongside her, we had Bree, who, well, actually Bree was not a first-timer. She competed 2019 as well. She did fall 2019. So going into this show, kind of 2 main goals. One was obviously to bring an improved physique, but 2 was to have a better prep. You know, Bree vocalized to me that her last prep was very hard, and, you know, in conversation, probably a lot harder than it needed to be from, you know, the extremity of the diet. Hi, buddy. How much cardio she was doing, and just the amount of, you know, like, issues that come out of prep, right? We won't go in too far into details on that kind of stuff, but the goal was to have a better prep, and that's definitely what we did. You know, we're ready to keep cracking on. She feels good. She doesn't feel mentally fatigued and physically just completely run down. She's in a good spot to now come out of prep and then, you know, pursue whatever comes next. And then Isabella, she was a first-timer. For a first-time competitor, I could not be happier with the work that she put in. She worked really hard. She really pushed herself. She followed the plan again. When there was challenges, we talked about it. We ironed things out, and we moved forward. And she brought, what are you doing? And she brought a physique to the stage that, you know, for a first-time competitor, I'm happy with, and it's only going to get better as time goes on. So for everybody across the board, all seven of you guys, I could not be more happy, couldn't be more proud of you all. You represented Team Rollins up there. We were the biggest team there, and it was awesome to see. And shout out to everybody that came out to support that didn't compete. We had a massive team photo, which I'll put up on screen right now, and that to me is pretty damn cool. So that's something that I'm extremely proud of. So I'm gonna close the video out here, guys. Again, I apologize for not getting, you know, maybe as much content as I would have liked to, and probably what a typical show day vlog would have looked like. But again, as you can imagine, trying to coach seven people, and you know, I'm running around all day, right? And it was hectic, it was a lot. And like I said, once I got into coaching mode, you know, the camera was the last thing I was thinking about at that time. So thanks again for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, give it a like, subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next one.